Okay. Now you need to find the roots of this characteristic equation. Those roots will be eigenvalues of given square matrix A. Okay. So previously we have seen there are two approaches to find roots of an equation. Okay. So let us start with the synthetic division method. Okay. So it is called characteristic equation. So in order to find the roots, let us start with synthetic division method. Okay. So you need to identify one value or one number so that the number satisfies this equation. Okay. Let us start with 1. Substitute lambda equals to 1. It will be minus 1 plus 5 minus 7 plus 3. It will be 8 minus 8, 0. Since the remainder is 0, you can conclude that lambda minus 1 is a factor, okay, and 1 is a root. Since the remainder is 0, you can conclude that 1 is a root. Now, go to synthetic division method. Lambda equals to 1. Take a box. Fill the first row with coefficients from highest to lowest. Minus 1, 5, minus 7, 3. Then put 0 here. Add these two, it will be minus 1. Now multiply these two, it will be minus 1. Now add these two, it will be 4. Now multiply these two, it will be 4. Now add these two, it will be minus 3. Now multiply these two, it will be minus 3. Okay. Now, from this table, you can conclude that lambda minus 1 is a factor. The other factor is minus lambda square plus 4 lambda minus 3 is equals to 0. So the coefficients are obtained minus 1, 4, minus 3 are the coefficients obtained from this synthetic division method. Okay. Now you need to find the other factors for minus lambda square plus 4 lambda minus 3 equals. Continuation of the previous step. Lambda minus 1 into minus lambda square plus 4 lambda minus 3 equals to 0. Okay. Now you need to divide the middle term into two terms so that sum of the two terms is 4 lambda and product of those two terms is 3 lambda square. Okay. So it is minus lambda square. Let us write 4 lambda is 3 lambda plus lambda minus 3 equals to 0. It is lambda minus 1 minus lambda into lambda minus 3 minus 1 into lambda minus 3 equals to 0. It is lambda minus 1 into lambda minus 3 into minus lambda minus 1 equals to 0. It implies the roots are 1 minus 1 and 3, and these are the eigenvalues of A. These are the eigenvalues of A. So this is the characteristic equation, or this is our equation. We have calculated the roots using synthetic division method. The roots are 1, minus 1 and 3. Now there is another approach to find the roots. The other approach is using scientific calculator. Now, how to find roots of this third degree equation using scientific calculator. Okay. Now let us press mod button in your scientific calculator several times. Okay. Press mod several times in your scientific calculator. Then you select the option equation. Okay. Select the option equation, then it is displaying unknowns 2 and 3. Okay. So our problem is not unknowns problem. Then select right side of replay button. So it is asking for degree 2 and 3. Select degree 3. Since our problem is of degree 3, select degree 3. Okay. Then it is asking for A. So type a number and press is equals to A is minus 1. Then B is 5. Type the number and press is equals to. Then C, C is minus 7, then D, D is 3. So you need to enter from highest coefficient to lowest coefficient. D value is 3. So the final answer is x1 is equals to 3. Again press is equals to, x2 equals to 1. Then so it is displaying x1 as, sorry, x2 as, okay. So there is a correction here, it is plus 1 and the roots are 113, okay. So calci given the roots as 3 and 1. Since it is of degree 3, you must get 3 roots, but you got only 2 roots. One root is 3, the other root is 1. So you are in short of one more root. So the third root can be calculated again using synthetic division method. Okay. So let us go to synthetic division method in order to find the other root. So minus 1, 5, minus 7, 3. Write 3 here, since 3 is the root. Write 0, add these two, it will be minus 1. Multiply these two, it will be minus 3, 2. Add, multiply these two, it will be 6. Add these two, minus 1. Multiply these two, it will be minus 3. Now again continue synthetic division method with the other root. Other root is 1. Put 0 here, add these two, it will be minus 1. Multiply these two, it will be minus 1. Add these two, 1. Multiply these two, 1. Add these two, 0. Okay. So it means lambda minus 3 is a factor. Lambda minus 1 is a factor. And minus lambda plus 1 is also a factor. It means the roots are 3, 1, 1. See, in scientific calculator also, you got the same roots, okay? But you are in short of one root. The remaining root is evaluated by using synthetic division method, okay? So finally, the eigenvalues for this problem are 1, 1, and 3. Now, I am going to find eigenvectors for the given square matrix, okay? So previously, we calculated eigenvalues for the square matrix A equals to 2, 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 0, 0, 1. Okay. Here the eigenvalues are 1, 1, 3. Now we need to find eigenvectors corresponding to these eigenvalues. Okay. So previously we calculated eigenvalues. Eigenvalues are 1, 1, 3. Now we need to calculate eigenvectors corresponding to eigenvalue 1 and eigenvalue 3. So let us start with eigenvalue of 1. Okay. So eigenvalue of 1 is a column matrix capital X satisfying the system A minus lambda I into capital X equals to null matrix. Here capital X is the column matrix, it cannot be null matrix, it cannot be null matrix. Lambda is eigenvalue 1, A is the given matrix, I is the identity matrix. So it will be 2, 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 0, 0, 1. Minus 1 into 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1 into capital X equals to null matrix. So it will be 2 minus 1, 1, 1, 1, then 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0. Into capital X equals to null matrix. Okay, so now there are two ways to find the eigenvector. Let us start with echelon form method. Okay, echelon form method is one method to find the eigenvector.